Hey guys, welcome back with another episode of Daily Alien. In a groundbreaking discovery by James Webb Telescope, for the first time in the history of space exploration, clear evidence of carbon dioxide has been found in the atmosphere of an exoplanet, WASP 93b. This observation was made by Webb's near-infrared spectrograph, NIRSpec, which observed WASP 39b during a transit over its star on July 10th, 2022, and was made public on August 25. In the resulting spectrum of the exoplanet's atmosphere, a small hill between 4.1 and 4.6 microns presents the first clear, detailed evidence of carbon dioxide ever detected in a planet outside the solar system. Previously, though, NASA's Hubble and Spitzer space telescopes have detected large amounts of water in the atmosphere of WASP 39b, which is a hot, bloated, Saturn-mass exoplanet that resides about 700 light-years from Earth. This exoplanet is estimated to have three times as much water as Saturn does. WASP 39b is currently positioned more than 20 times closer to its star than Earth is to the Sun, and completes an orbit around its star in every 4 days. This is a very important discovery, as carbon dioxide is the building blocks of life, and presence of carbon dioxide in exoplanet atmospheres increases chances of finding life everywhere in the universe. I mean, who knows? Maybe this planet has like intergalactic species that, like plants, have photosynthesis, but to be able to detect and measure carbon dioxide in the thinner atmospheres of smaller rocky planets, WASP 39b is a hot gas giant with a mass roughly basically quarter of Jupiter and a diameter 1.3 times greater than Jupiter. So its extreme puffiness, as you can imagine, is related to its partly to its high temperature. So we're talking about 900 degrees Celsius. Unlike the cooler, more compact gas giants in our solar system, WASP 39b orbits very closer to its star, only about 1/8 between the distance of Sun and Mercury. Imagine completing one circuit in just 4 days. The planet's discovery, reported in 2011, was made based on ground-based detections of the subtle periodic dimming of light from its host star as the planet transits or passes in front of the star, which is transit spectroscopy. We have a video about it right here. But previous observations from other telescopes, including Hubble and Spitzer, revealed the presence of water, vapor, sodium, and potassium in the planet's atmosphere. Webb's unmatched infrared sensitivity has now confirmed the presence of carbon dioxide as well. I mean, who knows what this planet carries? First clear detection of CO2 is a research team that used Webb's NIRSpec for its observation of WASP 39b, and they realized that in the spectrum of this exoplanet atmosphere, there's a very small hill between the microns presented, and they realize it is the first ever carbon dioxide discovered in the entire universe outside the solar system. As soon as the data appeared on my screen, the whopping carbon dioxide feature grabbed me, said Zafar Rastamkulov, a graduate student at Johns Hopkins University and a member of the JWST transiting exoplanet community. She was startled. She said it was a special moment crossing an important threshold in exoplanet sciences. Really, no observatory has ever measured such subtle differences in brightness of so many individual colors across the 3 to 5.5 micron range in an exoplanet transmission spectrum before. Access to this part of the spectrum, though, is crucial for measuring abundances of gases like water and methane, as well as CO2, which are thought to exist in many different types of exoplanets. However, detecting such a clear signal on carbon dioxide on WASP 39b bodes well for the detection of atmospheres on smaller terrestrial-sized planets. So understanding the composition of a planet's atmosphere is important because it tells us something about the origin of the planet and how it evolved, really. Carbon dioxide molecules, in this case, are sensitive tracers of the story of planet formation. By measuring this carbon dioxide, we can actually determine how much solid versus how much gaseous material was used to form this gas giant planet. In the coming decade, though, James Webb will make this measurement for a variety of planets, which is going to be proving insight into the details of how planets form and the uniqueness of our own solar system. So buckle up and get ready for this crazy ride, because the next few months and years, we're gonna really see some crazy cool shit. Anyways, if you like this video, you should check this feature right here, where we talk about the latest image of Jupiter by James Webb that the telescope discovered. We explain in detail. We also have a whole playlist coming up. Thank you so much for watching our videos. We make videos like this for free because of you. So a like, subscribe, or a comment would really, really help us. See you soon. All right, I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.